Alright, welcome to the iPad mini 6 unboxing. I ordered this iPad mini right after the Apple event and got delivered this morning. I'm so excited, the iPad mini finally got redesigned this year. So far, Apple has finally brought the all-screen design to all of its product lines. Let's get into it. It still retains the plastic packaging. This year's iPhone 13 has replaced with a paper seal. This is the config I bought, a 64GB Wi-Fi only version. My first impression is it is lighter and smaller than my expectation. Let's find out what else in the box first. Some warranty paper and the manual. It comes with a 20W USB-C charger with a Type-C cable as well. This purple looks very light. I like it. The bezel follows Apple's new family design. Also support a magnetic wireless charging of Apple Pencil. The aluminum materials is similar with the iPhone 12 and iPad Air. It equips a 12MP single lens back camera. The weight is very good, not far away from an iPhone 13 Pro Max. All the buttons are moved to the top side. The Touch ID is same to the iPad Air. It has 4 speakers, 2 on the top and 2 at the bottom. It changed to a Type-C port, it's a good thing. Apple Pencil, come on. It's time to start it up. The Touch ID setting is same to the iPad Air. It looks like a size shrink version of iPad Air. Let's have a tour of the system and some applications. The pre-installed system is already updated to the new iPad OS 15. It's a great big screen device to take with you to browse the daily agenda, check stocks, browse the website, and read the news. It's also a great device to watch videos. It has a much larger screen compared with a phone and a much lighter weight compared with a normal tablet. The Apple Pencil works well, but the writing experience is limited by the screen size. If you are a heavy user of stylus, I would more recommend a larger screen iPad. Apple powered this 8.3-inch tablet with the new A15 chip. Compared with the full power A15 on the iPhone 13 Pro Max, Apple kept the 5-core GPU but reduced the CPU clock frequency around 10%, and the RAM also cut to 4GB. Let's take a benchmark test. Finally, we got the single core around the 1600s and the multi-core around the 4400s. Compared with the A14, the multi-core is around 4% higher and the single core is even lower than A14. That's because this A15 is reduced 10% call frequency compared with the full power A15 on the phones. However, the best part of this A15 is the speed improvement of the neural engine. The benchmark score is even 14% higher than an iPad Pro. This could greatly improve the machine learning capability of this device. The last thing I want to talk is the display. Here is the head-to-head comparison with the two iPad Pros. According to my personal feelings, the screen is not as good as these two Pro machines. The main reasons are the poor color dynamic range and the low display refresh rate. I can easily feel the 60Hz refresh rate of the screen has a strong sense of the tear effect. If screen and budget are important to your iPad purchase, I highly recommend buying a used iPad Pro instead of this iPad Mini and iPad Air. I will have a full review of this iPad soon. Hope you can like this video. Thanks for your support. See you next time.